Soon, everyone, welcome back to Emnix Plays Path of Exile Breach League Hardcore. Last episode, we killed Brutus in. What did we kill him? In Act 1 Merciless. So we are. Yes, we are in Merciless now. Overall, our character, I mean, it's going pretty smoothly. What do I think of the damage at this point? I'm like, I've been flip flopping, you know, back and forth between the damage every episode. You know, one episode I think, you know, it's not that bad, which is what I'm thinking right now. And then halfway through, I'm like, you know what? This is like the worst thing ever. Like, this is hell, you know? So I guess if you feel like that, it means it's like average, I suppose. Like, there are times when we really feel like, oh, I wish I had a little bit more damage. There are times where it's like, you know what, it's not all that bad. But one thing I can say for sure is that our survivability really isn't all that bad. That's the one thing that I'm pretty happy about. It's basically what's carrying us through the game so far, which is essentially, you know, just the fact that we can block a lot of hits, we can tank a lot of stuff. You know, we're doing okay because of that. Now, I know I have Grace activated. I do want Grace. Yes, I want Grace over Determination. Right. Okay. So we should turn that back on whenever I get a chance. Okay. And then we're going Warlord's Mark over Poacher's Mark. Unfortunately, what that means is that we won't be able to get any more Frenzy Charges. However, the leech, the 2% leech or whatever that Warlord Marks provides us with, I think is a lot more important than, you know, the damage or mana on hit that we get from Poacher's Mark. The 4% damage is a big deal. However, if we don't even have the mana to cast the skill in the first place, then, like, what's the point, you know? So right now the idea is we're just gonna run with Warlord's Mark, get the leech, get the endurance charges. You know, the survivability is still good. That is, you know, 25% generate endurance charges. It's nothing to sneeze at, that's for sure. 25% chance? 26%. Yeah, it's pretty good. Now, obviously, let's see. It's 27% chance to get a frenzy charge with Poacher's Mark, but we just get too little mana back. What is it? 9 mana when they're hit by attacks. That's just way too low. It's not good enough. Not good enough. So, unfortunately, we can't use it right now. Maybe we can use it later on. I feel like in like a perfect world, you know, in the perfect situation is you would use Poacher's Mark and then use Red Nightmare for endurance charge generation. But you know, Red Nightmare is like 400 chaos, something ridiculous like that, so we obviously cannot afford it. But if I could, I would. Once again, we're playing one of those builds. It's like, if we had the currency, we could make this build really good. But right now, we have to play like this cheap knockoff of what we want our build to actually be. Which, I mean, it kind of sucks, but at the same time, that's sort of how character progression works, right? You start off pretty weak, you know, just like leveling, your gear needs to progress over time as well. It's just kind of sad that when we play in Hardcore League, it's like, once we die, we actually lose a lot of the money that we've earned, because we need to rebuy gear, we need to buy leveling gear again, and then we need to, like, gear up for the late game, and if we happen to die, which is what happened to us, all that money we spent is now lost to the ether, also known as standard. So that's a little unfortunate. The fact that, you know, we don't have much money in now, don't have all that much to spend on new gear. Kind of have to save up, kind of have to just be a little bit more cheap. You know, if we can save money here and there, we should try to. But, I mean, overall, though, given what we had, I think we've been pretty effective, you know, with our resources. So far, so good. Going through it pretty quickly. Wait, did I get the boss already? No. Here she is. Strangle Charm. I don't understand what Strangle Charm is. Is it actually like the embodiment of like some spirit who happened to strangle the girl, or is just the monster who happens to be named Strangle Charm? I mean, what is it really? Like, somebody explain this to me. It must. I mean, my mind is clearly not working that well right now. I swear to God, we just had, I don't know, like 30 seconds of like radio silence on the recording, because I was just like, the rhythm of the Blade Flurry was like getting to me, like I was just listening to the rhythm, like just listening to it. That's what I was doing. So the fact that there was a little bit of dead air, you know, I apologize. The sound of the Blade Vortex, or the Blade Flurry, sorry, is mesmerizing, I have to say. Like, I just, the hits, man, they just lull you to sleep. It's essentially what happened to me. Alright. Fair Graves. So today we're probably just going to kill Merville. Do a little bit of Act 2. I don't know how much we can do today. We'll try to do as much as we can. So now we got our passive point. And we're getting good EXP too. That's the one thing that we have kind of going for us. And I think after, maybe after Act 2, we can pick up our Cruel Ascendancy. I still haven't figured out when I want to pick up my Merciless Ascendancy, but it'll probably be pretty soon. I would say level 70 maybe is when we go pick it up. 73, 74. Because we need that gratuitous violence pretty badly. And if we have to like grind out Izaro, I'm willing to do that. Just as long as it's not too difficult, I don't know. I hope we can do it. Like, Izaro is like a 67 zone or something like that, maybe 68. I mean, if we just farm Dried Lakes for until we get to level 73, 74, go do Izaro, it might not be all that bad. I'm actually pretty excited to do that. The moment we get all three ascendancies, like, shit will be popping, I'm just saying, you know. Our build will really start picking up then. I'm hyping it up, but that's basically what I hope for. I'm not sure if it'll work or not. You know, I'm not sure if the combination of gratuitous violence, knockback, and whatnot will work with, you know, the gear that we have. A lot of it honestly relies on the surrender. But we can't afford that, so this Enfeeble is like an alchemy, so we should pick that up. Okay. That is done. Let's just keep moving. Get to Merville as soon as we can. Should I open up that breach? I should, but in Merciless, just too dangerous. I can't open up any breaches in Merciless until I get Spellblock. That's basically how I feel about it. I don't want to take that risk just yet. I don't think I'm ready. My body's not ready. So let's just keep going, get the CXP, get the levels. It's kind of unfortunate that I can't open breaches, because this character is supposed to be a breach killer. You know? It's supposed to be super successful within the breaches. But we're not ready just yet. We will be, you know, it may be in 3 or 4 more days. But we're going to have to wait a bit. This is not the right way. But yeah, so for now, you know, the Blade Flurry dream will carry on. Not that it's much of a dream since we didn't really build into it, but at the very least, I hope the Blade Flurry dream is carrying on. And what's a dream really? Just that it won't, you know, get us killed. That's the dream. I had a dream that every skill was pretty strong, and Blade Flurry was one of them. Basically it. Okay. Just gotta be patient with her. I think we are doing very well. You know what? The Blade Flurry dream is real. Who am I kidding? Even with minimal investment, we're doing pretty well. So, pretty happy about that. Halfway there. Okay, we're running out of mana. That's a bit of a problem. Okay, we're good. We're good. Okay, I think we're doing it. Almost there. And then we'll be in Act 2. That's exciting. That's slowly getting to the point where we died last time.
Ladies first, fair Mervale.
Which is, it's kind of nice. We get to redeem ourselves once again. What am I doing? Okay. I guess this is good. I'll check the sword. Why is this here? There. Alright, Southern Forest. Into Act 2 we go. It's only 12 minutes, so we have some time to progress through Act 2 a little. Let's sell some stuff. Hold on. Nope. These are some shitty ass gloves. Look at that. That's like a level 10 glove. Maybe even worse. 7 life, 4 evasion, 9 strength. It's so bad. Okay, so the award. A reward. I probably. Let's go with that. Go with the passive point. And go with that. Are they any good? The gloves, not too good. Okay.
Welcome.
Is there anything? Are you selling any 6 sockets? No. There's a chrome here. I'll take it. And that looks like it's about it. Okay. And then we get a passive point over here. Got this. Alright. Slowly stacking up the currency, so that's good. But there's still so much more we gotta go for. Just insane. Enfeeble we can probably sell for 1 more alchemy. Alright. Act 2. Act 2 it is. And then, so Act 2 should be pretty easy, going through the leveling, especially in like Southern Forest, Western Forest, these areas are just prime leveling spots. You know what? I'm gonna open up the breach. Why the hell not? The reason is because we might die? Am I dying? I guess we're okay for now. But this is a little scary. Our damage is just really bad. But we're getting good currency though, that's the thing. I feel like not opening these breaches is such a waste. Look at that. I mean, we've got a fusing in here. That's pretty good. Just good quantity. Oh, double hands! Okay, I think I opened them. I got him. Good. Let's take that fusing. Look, any currency is good currency, okay? We just got to, it's baby steps, man. Baby steps. Gotta take it one step at a time. Another breach? I mean, don't mind if I already did. Getting surrounded is not good, though. Y'all. But seriously, though? My hand is super itchy right now. I need to scratch it. But I can't. I'm scratching real quick. Taking my hands off the keyboard. Okay. Alright, that was good. That was good. We got a splinter. Got another fusing. Just like that, man. Two fusings. That's almost a chaos, you know? Slowly, making our way up in the world. Just gaining ground. Working our way up. Okay. I think there's another breach. I saw it. Why are there three breaches in here? Hold on. That's insane. Over here? Yeah, there it is. Okay. Okay, let's clear this pack first. Tempest Shield. And let's see, it's a tool breach. We should probably kill the monkey. Oh god, this might kill us. Be careful. Okay, we're good. You're so tanky! How do you kill them? Alright, well, look, if we were playing our reverse knockback cyclone whatever build, this wouldn't be a problem, okay? I'm just saying. I'm looking forward to it. I can't wait till I get there. But right now, we're just going to have to suffer through this period of no damage whatsoever. It sucks, I know. But, it'll get better. It'll get better, I promise. Okay, let's see. These rings. Nope. This one? Nope.
Going.
Okay. Let's go get our passive point. It's still the 18 minute mark, so we still have 12 minutes to go before I want to cut off the episode. Still lots of time. Plenty of time. We can do this. All right. Just gotta get through these monkeys. I mean, it's good EXP, right? Like, you don't mind when there's a lot of monkeys in the way. Because you can just mow them down very quickly. Like, all of these Act 2 zones, even though I don't like them too much, I have to admit, like, they all have low EX or low HP, but they give a lot of EXP, you know? So that's, like, one of the good things about it. Oh, God, I wish I had a movement skill that actually lets me, like, leap across or whatever. That'd be kind of nice, wouldn't it? Damn it. I mean, Whirling Blades is nice, it's fast and stuff, but it doesn't let me, like, clear gaps, which kind of sucks. Ebon Render? Really? That's his name? Shaggy Crawl the Parch. See, that's a cooler name. These names all remind me of like, what was that game? Mordor? Middle Earth? Shadows of Mordor? Where they all had like some ridiculous name. Like the orcs come out and it was like, Dick Punch, Dick Punch. I am Dick Punch. You will regret that you are fighting me. And then like, you kill him and then fucking like a toxin kill. See, that would be like a orc name in Middle Earth. And you kill him and later on they're like, surprise, I'm back, I'm not actually dead. You just like fucking gave me a scar on my neck that will never disappear, but I'm still around. Actually, Middle Earth was a pretty good game. I should play it some more. I never actually beat it. Just kind of, you know, it's one of those games that you play for fun. You can dick around, kill orcs. It's pretty enjoyable. Oh, I would like to kill you so badly. Please let it happen. Go into that guy. Go in. Go. Ah! Why? The rare was right there for the taking. Why would you do this? Oh. Ghost AI is just so disappointing. I worked so hard to push him into a rare. Is this how I get rewarded? Not at all. Alright. Western Forest. At the very least, let's get our passive point today. And I suppose I could also kill Alira. Now the question does become, do I want the Endurance Charge or do I want the Frenzy Charge? I think since we're in Hardcore, the answer is we want the Endurance Charge. If it was Softcore, I would definitely pick the Frenzy. But at the moment, like, I'm not even running Poacher's Mark, right? So is there any point? Probably not. Grime Knife the Throat Slitter. What a catchy name. Oh god, they all explode. Okay, keep running.
Spirit is spent.
Okay. Whoa! That almost killed me. What the hell is that? I don't know what it was, but it did a lot of damage. So we gotta be careful here.
Hello.
Let's sell some more stuff. Probably we didn't get anything good. I mean, that's just... Whoa. This is okay. 77 life, 23 cold resistance, 28 lightning resistance. You just gotta craft some fire resistance and you're good to go, man. Yo.
Going.
This is actually a pretty good helmet. I'm just saying. It's missing intelligence. It doesn't matter. Fire. What do we have? 104, 94, 81. We're level 61. What happens if I take this off? Okay. So we craft fire resistance on this thing. Yeah. That's pretty good. It has more armor. A lot more armor. Probably has better resistances. Yeah, it does. Fuck yeah. We got ourselves an upgrade. Reckoning. Increased duration, cast when damage taken, immortal call. Now, we're still not ready to put on the Formless Inferno, and once we do, minus 30 fire resistance is kind of a big deal, I'm just saying. So we need to figure out a way to fix that. But in the meantime, let's do it up. Just keep going. Easy upgrade. 101, 117, 99. Those are pretty good resistances, I must say. I think we'll be getting a lot of resistances from our shield, though. Like our Cressa Parandus, we're probably going to switch that very soon. Alright, got the emblem. Currently 26 minutes. We still have some time, so let's go run over to Alira and kill her. And then we can go to the Weaver's Chambers as well if we have the time. And get... what is this? Oh my god, he hurts. Is this what did all that damage last time?
My spirit is spent.
Oh, he's hexproof. I can't regenerate mana. Oh no. Oh no. This is not good. I'm just default attacking him. Okay, well. We did it, but that was painful, absolutely painful. If I can't regenerate mana, or if I can't curse people, how do I leech mana? That's actually like a super weakness. I didn't even realize. Okay, definitely can't kill this ghost. I'm not even gonna try. It's just not happening. Hey. Alright, so we want to kill Alira. She corpse exploded the corpse of the boss! Good times, man. For those of you who don't know, that was like an old school reference to Kriparian, who used to play Path of Exile. Those were the days where he used to drink OJ instead of whatever the fuck he drinks now.
It's hard to cast a spell,
like root beer or something.
Throat, isn't it, witch?
I don't know. But yeah, he was one of those guys that actually got me into Path of Exile. You know, I would say he's the one who introduced me to this game for sure. I remember watching so many of his videos, following his builds, even though they weren't maybe that good. But at the time, like, he was pretty innovative. And I remember playing Diablo 3 and being just really disappointed. And just going out there looking for games to play that were similar, you know, in... similar in size, similar in theme, you know, similar to feel. Like, I remember trying to play Borderlands. Because they too had like RNG generated loot. One of the biggest things actually I enjoy about game is the fact that loot is RNG. You know, I'm tired of those MMORPGs where in order to get a better item it's just you plus one something. And then, oh, there's a chance of this item to break if you try to, you know, make it plus four. And if you break it, you gotta start it from plus one again, and then like there's your currency sink. Instead, you know, games like this, games like Borderlands, you know, Path of Exile, ARPGs in general, you have randomized loot. And yes, it makes the game like kind of unbalanced or imbalanced, since really there's no, like in MMOs you just kind of grind for the best gear and then after that it's skill. But in Path of Exile you could all, like, no two pieces of gear, unless you have a unique item, but no two pieces of gear are really the same. And then that probably messes with balance a lot. I mean, you can tell already. Path of Exile has some serious balance issues. Things are not balanced well, and I don't think they're meant to be. Like, the developers try to do their best, but they can only do so much. But like, I'm totally fine with that. That's what I want to play. You know, I made this decision for myself. So I'm okay with it, but I'm sure there are some who don't. Which is why there are some who do prefer games like, you know, World of Warcraft or whatever, like an MMO, where gear is more either like it's based on drop, like, oh, only certain bosses are able to drop this specific item, and then everybody tries to farm for the item, and that's like the best in slot, like literally the best item, right? I mean, we already have that kind of in Path of Exile, where we have a lot of unique items which are considered best in slot. Like for me, the anvil is my best in slot, right? Well, not specifically the anvil itself, like the base item anvil, and then you can get like, you know, good enchantments, good veil enchantments and whatnot. God, I can't kill this thing. I'm trying, but I can't. Yo. My one dream is to just kill this one thing, and then I'm done. I'll be happy. There you go. Killed it. But yeah, like I was saying, you know, being able to drop just... The fact that, you know, anything can potentially drop, you know, whether it's good or bad... It really intrigued me, which is why it got me into this game. But yeah, I remember back then just playing Diablo and being like, man, I need something else. This isn't working for me. And finding Path of Exile and just going, you know what? I remember at the time going like, you know what? This is a game that I could stick with for a long time. Like, I just knew that. And here I am. I mean, it's been a very long time. When did Diablo 3 come out? 2011. I think I got into it the summer of 2012, maybe. I got into Path of Exile. Either way, it's been a long time, almost 5 years, at least 4 years. Been playing for a long time, and I still freaking absolutely adore this game. Yo, but seriously, dog? Why am I taking so much damage? Like, this is not cool. Chaos damage? Is that what it is? Okay, you get close. Fortify up. And then just go ham. Wow, he dropped the map. Cool. We're at that point already, huh? Where maps start dropping. That gets me excited, man. Slowly getting back into the map game. Alright, let's see. Sell.
Travel far.
Talk to Silk. I don't know. This?
Hello.
Nope. It has a lot of armor. But not much else.
Travel far.
So we got a little bit of currency today, not too much. We're still sitting at 7 chaos. So poor. I can't help it, okay? This is just our speed. Anyways, next time around, let's try to finish up Act 2. But that's the end of this episode. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, as always, you can leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more updates in the future. Otherwise, keep in touch, guys. And I'll see you guys next time.
How you go?
Soon.